Hey people, what is up? I just got this package from a friend of mine, and judging by the weight of it, there's a whole lot of fun inside here, so we're gonna bust it open and see what's going on inside there. I got my Benchmade 32. That's what we're gonna use to open the package, and let's do it. Now, I don't actually know what's in here myself, so it's going to be a surprise. Got to be careful whenever I don't know what's in there because I don't want to cut nothing up. I don't want to go too deep with it. You know what I mean? All right, let's put that aside. See what's going on over here. All right, I gotta read this first. Hold on, y'all. Please read first. All right. I don't know if he wants me to read it on air or not, but hold on a minute, y'all. I'm going to cut this so I can read this right quick so it's not no dead air. But, you know, either way, hold on. All right, y'all. I just finished reading the letter. And basically what it was telling me what to expect in the box. And for those of you that don't know, this is my contest prize from my boy King Camo 123 from the little contest he was doing there. And, you know, according to the letter, he done went above and beyond in this box, y'all. So, like I said before, if you haven't checked out King Camo 123, y'all, get your butt over there and check him out. He's a good guy. A friend of mine, so. Comes highly recommended. And he gave me some goodies in here, so we're going to bust it open and see what all they are. All right. Can't wait to go through this thing, y'all. What we got here? We got a Bushnell hat. I definitely don't mind rocking that brand. I represent Bushnell any day. They make some good stuff, y'all. Good stuff. I used to have some Bushnell optics on my Ruger 1022s. I used to build custom 1022s. And unfortunately, I sold most of them. But I used Bushnell optics on a few of them. And man, those were some good optics. So I definitely don't mind rocking the brand. And that color right there, I got a lot of that color. A lot of camo. And, you know, that's a good color. So thank you for that right there, bro. I always wear the hats, too. All right. What's this right here? We got us a tripod light, it looks like. Flashlight. Tripod legs, so you can have some light wherever you want. I've seen one of these before. Never actually picked one up. Don't know really how they work too much. I'll have to fuck around with it and see what's going on, but got your, what's this, open? That's how you open it up, okay. I see what it does there. You lock it up and you push the button. Opens it up one-handed. So that's cool. You could just have it like a flashlight, you know. Use it how you need. If you need to pop it down on the ground with one hand, you just kind of pop that. It opens up for you. That's pretty slick right there. Looks like it got a pretty high intensity LED and a good reflector in there, so I'm anxious to try this one out. Thank you so much for that, bro. That's awesome right there. I'll definitely use that. I need light all the time. Alright, what do we got going on here? There's that CRKT. I'll save the knives for last. Alright. There's, what's that? That's a Sam Ramu knife. Got a Crown Royal bag. Hell yeah. Love those Crown Royal bags. Check it out, y'all. Shake all that white stuff out of it. All that stuff off the peanuts. But yeah, Crown Royal. Definitely a fan of Crown Royal. And those bags are good for storing stuff. You can, you know, put all kinds of stuff in them bags. I mean, you can put your guns in there too. It helps keep them a little bit away from the moisture. I've done that. Drop a gun in there and then throw a couple of silica packets in there with your guns if you want to store them for a while. I've done that. All right, what else we got going on here? What's this? Man, look at that. A duct tape blade, man. It's like a custom kind of duct tape. It got duct tape on the handle right there. And you got your little, done some little file work on the back, it looks like. Kind of hard to see. My lighting is off where I'm at in the floor. That's cool, man. I used to always do stuff like that, too. I once did a, you know those old balisong, or not balisong, but the old switchblade, like the 50s stilettos. They had combs. You know, you shoot the little blade out and it'd be a comb on there where you can comb your hair. Well, I used to get those and I would take the comb part out, the little black plastic, and it had a little slot where the comb part set in, this little metal rail. And you know, the comb was pinched in there with the metal. I would pop that plastic piece out and get a steak knife, you know, and break the blade off, or like, you know, pull it out of the handle or whatever, cut it however I could do it, and get it in there. And like kind of clamp it down on it, you know. It worked for a while. But my mom started getting pissed off whenever all the steak knives, well, whenever there was only handles in the drawer, she was wondering where all the steak knife blades went. And of course I told her I didn't know, you know. But we ran out of knives a lot when I was growing up. So, you know, stuff like that is cool to me. I like that right there, man. Got a sheath. Check that out. A duct tape sheath. How cool is that, y'all? That's just cool. Alright, what else we got in here? We got a sheath for a maglite, it looks like. And I think, yeah, there's that maglite right there. Got the blue anodized. Never can have too many flashlights around the house, y'all. I'm telling you that. Anybody that knows what I'm talking about knows what I'm talking about. But especially in my neck of the woods, we get a lot of storms, a lot of power outages. Flashlights are good. So, and I love that blue color too. I got a couple of extra spare LED conversions for maglites. I might drop a LED conversion in that bad boy right there. I got a lot of the bulbs too. But either way, we got some candies. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, man. Look at that. Lifesavers. Brother, how did you know? Lifesavers are easily one of my top five favorite candies. I love Lifesavers. I could just eat the damn Lifesavers all day. There's more. Me and my mom and sister used to fight over who gets the red ones. So damn right on them, man. I got a tube for M&M Minis, and that's what that maglite was in. That actually makes a damn good storage tube, too, for anything, really. Good thing there. Got some paracord going on here. Some paracord bracelets. A white paracord bracelet. Hell yeah, man. Could definitely use a white one. I got my white Endura. Just got my brand new white Nikes. I'm wearing a white shirt right now. Just got that. So I like me some white. Got another one here with a green and black. Now that's just sweet right there. I love that green. That green and that black looks good together. I love how the green is running through the middle, too. See, I still don't know how to make these. I mean, you know, I got a buddy of mine sent me a couple of good videos on how to do it, but I need to get some paracord and start doing this shit. That looks like a double stitch, or maybe the same type of deal, but just fatter inside. This one's thicker, see? That's cool. I don't have any of the thicker ones. All right, brother. Thank you so much for that. What we got here? We got some shooting glasses, I think he said. Some camo shooting glasses. Always like the shooting glasses. Don't want that brass hitting you in the eye. So definitely good there. Let's see what else we got going on here. What's this? It's a clear duct tape or a clear, that's a tape wallet. Yeah. Like a clear little wallet right there. See, it shows how you put your stuff card pockets and the cash pocket, whatever. Put your bill back there. That's pretty neat right there, man. You could just, you know, you just use that right there for a clear wallet, man. I've never seen one of that. One of those. That's pretty cool. I never actually seen a duct tape wallet made in person. Here's another one. Same type of deal going on here. You got your little card pockets. Got your bill pocket right there. And that thing feels pretty thick too. Man, those feel better constructed than some of the wallets you see for $20. But that's cool right there, man. I like the duct tape wallets. Definitely a slim wallet. You can use that. See there? Real slim. I like that. I might have to learn how to make those too. What we got here? We got like a scarf or a throw kind of. Makes a good backdrop. Makes a good cover for things if you want to cover something up. I got a big cedar chest in here I could use this on. Throw it on top of there, so, you know, makes a nice cover for it there. I don't want to undo it all right now, because I don't really feel like folding it all back up, but it looks like it got kind of a Middle Eastern feel to it. I mean, it's a real light material. Pretty damn cool right there, y'all. Pretty cool. See that? That's cool. Lots of goodies in here, man. He said it was going to be a lot of stuff, but, man. Oh, there's some more lifesavers. Hell yeah. Those will be gone tonight. Carabiners. Gotta love the carabiners. Definitely use those. Here's a little flashlight. Little push-button keychain flashlight. See there? Little single LED in there. I had a green one like this at one point, and I used the hell out of that thing. You can replace the batteries in these too. Take these little screws out, so these are replaceable or you know, reusable, whatever. But they make a real good light on your keys if you need to get into the house right quick and you can't really see what's going on around you. Make a good key for that. I mean, a good light for that. Just a quick light to have. You know, they don't run down because, you know, they don't come on accidentally. At least they don't stay on, you know. Just a temporary. Good little lights right there. Let's see what else we got. Oh, we got that badass peasant knife. And I think that's it. Packing. Oh, here's this right here. Yeah. Another one of them badass, what I call a DNA, or like a Solomon something or other. Those are just badass, man. I definitely love these. My boy Ospy made me a gray one like this that I use a lot. This one right here, this green, and you got the lime, kind of the lime, you know, brighter green, and then you got the more OD type of green. Love that, man. Definitely will use that. Now let's check out the knives. Let's put all these goodies over here. Now, never mind my dog haired carpet. I don't know if this high definition camera is going to pick up the dog hair, but I do have dog hair in the carpet as well as pieces of packing peanut. All right, man, check that out. Sword, peasant knife. I still got to do that review on my other one, my orange one. But, man, the two that I would have picked. Now, both of these, I got an orange one and I got this one. Both of them were sent to me by friends. I didn't buy any of them. But I planned on buying more. And the two colors I would pick are orange and blue. No shit. And the wood handle one. I like that one, too. But if I would have bought them myself, I definitely would have went with orange and the blue. And look at that. I just love that color blue on there. You don't get much better than that color. Got a lot of oil on it here. Keep it preserved. See there? Lots of oil. Look at that thing, man. Them things are just too clean. I use that other, my other peasant a lot. I still got to do the review on it. But yeah, that thing right there, man, is just a cool knife. If y'all don't know about these peasant knives, like I said, I'll try to do the review on it, but I mean, these are just some really good, handy knives to have around. And these bastards come sharp. Man, that feels sharp too. I know my other one came really sharp. This one feels like it too. I'm not gonna cut nothing with it yet, but if it's like my other one, it'll be damn sharp. And if you just do a little bit of, you know, touch up on your sharp maker or whatever, you can get these things scary. I'm telling you. So, they got a good steel on them. All right, what else we got going on here? Let's bust this open. There's a pecan peanut. We got us a little razor knife. These right here are very useful. You could drop these on a keychain if you want. You know, you got a long run of razor, which is good for a lot of things. Some knives, some of the razor knives, you only get a little, you know, about maybe that much. I mean, and then some of the ones you slide out, you can get that much, but they're segmented. So if you do too much with them, you can kind of break off the segments. These right here I find good for a lot of different things. You got a little handle right here you can grip onto if you want. And kind of push down. And you can, you know, do some flat cutting. And you can actually shave with these damn things. Ask me how I know. But yeah, these things right here, these are infinitely handy. If you need a blade, make a hell of a package opener too. Alright, let's check out this little Sam Renmu box. See what's up in here. Little silica gel packet. Oh shit, that is sweet. Damn, it's got a little pocket clip on it too. Look at that burgundy, y'all. It's like a, let me see if I can get the light. I gotta do the light on this one, y'all. Hold on. Come on, focus. Please. It's not gonna focus real good, I guess, but man, if y'all can see, it's like a burgundy or a maroonish type of, I guess a G10 or like a plastic. What is that? That's like a G10, yeah. A little G10, then you got this kind of black. Hold on, let me get my light. So y'all gotta see this. I'm gonna try to get this. I don't know if you can pick up the little black lines in it. But it's like a real nice dark red, and then whenever you look at a certain way, you look at, you know, you shift the handle here, you can kind of pick up black in there. And then got a little pocket clip, and let's take out the blade, shall we? Oh, that's smooth, y'all. That's smooth. Oh, shit. My hands are greasy as hell from or oily from that, I'll wipe them on a carpet. I gotta clean it anyway. Let's try to do this without cutting the shit out of myself. How about it? Those things come out quick whenever you get them. You got to get your hold right on them. Ooh, see? I almost cut myself. I'm not used to it yet, y'all. Yeah, I might have to get used to this one. Shit. No, I didn't get myself, but damn, I almost did. You got to do it just right. There you go. See, I'm not usually played with knives this small that open that fluidly, so you got to play with them and get it just right, because if you know, you kind of want to tend to go up on that blade like I did just a minute ago, so you got to kind of move your thumb up and out of the way like that, because it's smaller and, you know, it's just the physics of it. But man, that's cool right there. Oh, I can see this blade right here being one of those ones I carry a lot, y'all. It's just a good size. You got a double kind of finger choil thing going on there. I do reviews on them. And now I got to cut something. Hold on. Let me get this piece right here. Yeah, it's got a little bit of toothiness to it. It's sharp. But it's got a little bit of toothiness to it. So I'm going to have to do a little touch on it. Because it wants to bite in more than it wants to slice right now. But that's not a problem at all. Definitely a cool looking little blade right there. I'm definitely going to have to get this one sharpened up to carry. Alright, what are we at? 20 minutes? Damn. Or more than that probably, if I got to clip the first part in here. Alright, here's our CRKT. Oh hell, look at that. Look at that. That's one of the knives my boy King Camo was showing right there. Let's see if I can do this. Now my hands are super, super oily. I'm gonna have to like, hold on a minute, y'all. I'm gonna have to get me like a wet wipe or something. I don't wanna slip up on this shit, but either way, you do something. There you go. Push down, and when you come back up, it opens it, okay. That's how you do it, and then you got your liner lock. See, oh, he got a lot of oil on this one too, man. So it's nice and oiled. Yeah, I'm going to have to keep my hands, you know, I'm going to have to clean it up off the pearlized stuff here. Definitely don't want to slip on it, but let's try that again. I got to get used to it. I never had one of these. He was telling me about them. Ha, there you go. And of course, move your liner out of the way. Yeah, I'd definitely rather have more oil on my blade than not, especially during transit. So, you know, not a problem there. I'm real glad that there's the oil all over it, you know. Not complaining about that because, you know, you definitely don't want your blades getting rusted up or anything like that, depending on what climate they go through or whatever. But I'll have to take care of the oil on the handle. But that's just too cool. You got the little, the pocket clip. Looks like it's going to be a place where you could grab and push down here, so it helps a little bit. Pretty strong pocket clip too. You know what? My wife's gonna try to steal this one, y'all. I guarantee you, she's gonna try to steal it. But can't do that, man. That's just clean right there. It's got that real sexy look to it, real elegant. The pink, I like the pink on it. I'm not one of those dudes that would not carry a pink knife. I mean, you got them dudes out there, you know, oh, I couldn't carry a pink knife or a pink gun. Or, you know, I don't give a shit, man. I think that looks good right there. I carry a damn pink knife, man. I like it. I think that's just a clean-looking blade, too. Definitely. All right, I'll quit rambling on, y'all. Hell, let's... I'm carrying on, but, man, that's just too cool of you, brother. I really do appreciate it so much, man. That's from my boy King Camo 123, y'all. Y'all need to get over there and check the boy out, man. He's a very good guy, very good guy. You know? Got some good videos up. Doing his damn thing over there. So, that's a friend of mine, so go check him out, y'all. And I'm going to go and I'm going to put all this stuff somewhere. Because it's all over the place. Lots of goodies. And I'm going to finish off all these lifesavers. And that's about it. So, once again, thank you, bro. That's way more than generous. And I'm going to have reviews and rambling and all that crap on all the stuff here. I mean, on the knives, you know, on the little tripod flashlight here. I'm fixing to throw some batteries in this bad boy. Or actually, he already included some batteries in there. That's cool as hell. Check it out. Right here, you got your little button. Pretty good beam on that thing. And yeah, and then you got your little button here. Boom, open up your tripod leg. And you know, you can get your little light where you need it. See my dirty floor here that I got to vacuum. But yeah, man, I like that a lot. That's just cool. I'll be using that. All right, y'all. I'm going to get out of here now. Life's short, y'all. Stay sharp.